So you're looking to start touring with your band in 2022. In today's video, we're going to discuss the ins and outs of booking this tour by yourself and what you should consider when doing so. We're going to talk about everything from how you're going to plan where to tour to figuring out some logistics to make sure that the touring is as smooth as possible, and also how to find places to play and what to say in messages that you send so that you can actually make sure you book the dates. So let's get into all that and more. Welcome to Punk Rock 101. This is episode number 7 of Punk Rock 101. First things first, if you could please hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm, it really does help me out. If you're new here, my name is AJ and my musical project is called Shakeout. On this channel, I make videos about punk rock music and punk rock advice. If that sounds like something you're interested in, these videos are weekly, so please hit that subscribe button. So I've been touring for nearly a decade and started booking my own tours when I was in college. Every single break or weekend that we had, we would go out and play. And I've continued to book my own tour since, and trust me, it's not always the easiest thing to do. However, getting in a van and playing music with my friends has been one of the best things I've ever done, even when it gets difficult. And honestly, some of the best experiences of my 20s have been because of touring. So let's hop into my first tip when booking your own tours, which is to start small and to plan way ahead. Assuming that you've already been playing shows in your hometown area, start looking at places that are surrounding that area, maybe only a few hours away. So for example, I live in the New York City area. I'm super fortunate because New Jersey, Massachusetts, Philadelphia are all within only a few hours from my house. I know that not every part of the country in the world is like this, and some people might have to drive a little bit longer, but generally speaking, I would say try to stick within 4 or 5 hours of where you've already been playing. And just stick to booking like a show or two at a time. Trying to book like a 1 or 2 week tour could get really stressful, especially if you've never done it before. So just start with some weekends. Book 2 or 3 shows in a row that are only just a few hours from each other. This will help get you started on teaching you the skills that you need and kind of give you a taste of what touring and tour booking is like without losing a bunch of time and money. And you ideally want to start planning these shows anywhere from 3 to 6 months before they actually happen, because this is going to give you enough time to book and promote them. If you start planning a tour in December that you want to happen in January, you're going to run into some problems. All right, so our next step before you start booking anything is to actually plan out the route for your tour. Where do you want to go? One major piece of advice I have when planning your tour route is to think about the drives between each show. You want to play to different crowds every night, but you also don't want to be spending 7 hours in a van each day to do so. Touring starts to become a little bit miserable when you spend 7 hours in a van each day just to get to the next city in time to load in for the show. It also becomes really expensive for gas when you have to drive that much in between shows. Sometimes it's unavoidable and you just have to take a long drive on a tour. But whether your tour is 3 days or 3 weeks, I suggest keeping the drives as short as possible. I think the sweet spot is like 3 to 4 hours of driving between each show, honestly. Another tip I have for when planning your tour route is to consider playing smaller towns and suburbs. A lot of people automatically think of the biggest cities to play, like I wanna play New York City or I wanna play Boston. But honestly, there's always a lot of competition with shows in those places. You might be playing at the same time as 20 other shows on any given night. Whereas if you played the suburbs or towns surrounding those cities, a lot of times you end up playing the only show happening that night. Hence, you'll get a bigger turnout. Honestly, some of the best shows I've played have been in really small towns. It's just something to consider. So now once you've kind of locked in some sort of tour route, I suggest making a spreadsheet. I personally use Google Sheets. On this spreadsheet, you want a list of the dates, what cities you plan to go to, and then maybe a column for venues and local bands that are in that area. I actually use a color coding system of mine where I highlight the rows green once I've completely confirmed a show. Keeping track of your tour booking like this will help just make things a lot smoother and help you stay on track and see what work you still have to get done to book the whole thing. So once you've planned out your tour route and you've made your spreadsheet, it's time to actually start booking your tour. If you're new to this, honestly, it's gonna take quite a bit of research. You have to figure out what local bands and what venues exist in the towns and cities that you're trying to play in. My biggest suggestion is to try to find the local bands first. They are so much more important to your show than where the show is gonna be. Because you could play a super nice venue, but if there's no good local bands on the bill to draw in the local crowd, it doesn't really matter. Whereas if you play with the 2 best local bands in some kid's basement, the show is probably gonna be pretty awesome. And more likely than not, if you can find a local band or two that wants to play the show with you, they'll be able to point you in the right direction or even just book the local venue for you. So the question becomes, how do you find these bands and venues? A few great places to look include just a simple Google search. So maybe just type in the town you want to play and live music or live music venues. And then maybe see which bands have played those venues and try to do your best to gauge if they have a draw or not. Another great place to look is Facebook groups. There's a ton of DIY musician groups on there, and there's actually some for specific places. So there may be a group like North Carolina Local Shows or Virginia's Punk Bands. So just try to find these kinds of groups and then just scroll through them. Figure out which bands are active and where they're playing. Another place you could look to find some venues and bands are other bands' tour flyers. Look at other smaller bands that are out and touring and just see where they're playing and who they're playing with. And then just look into those venues and bands. And then once you've done this research and you've kind of figured out some venues and bands in each place that you want to go to, make sure to enter that information into your spreadsheet. This will just help keep you organized and let you know who you need to reach out to. Ideally, you want to have more than one contact for each place that you're trying to go to, because realistically, you're probably not going to be able to book all the shows in one shot. So now that we've done all this research, it's time to start sending out some messages. Like I said, I would personally hit up the bands first. Send them an email or even a DM on Instagram and just tell them which date you're trying to play and maybe even how you found out about them. And then ask if they'd be interested in playing with you on that date. A big tip I have for when you're doing this is to offer a show trade. Can you book their band in your hometown and just return the favor? Because if so, that'll make it more likely that they'll want to play with you because they also get something out of it down the line. And if you can find a local band or two that are willing to play with you at each date, they may have already offered to book the venue for you. But even if they haven't, it's going to make it a lot easier to reach out to the venue because now you can say, hey, I have a show full of bands that are going to bring people out. We just need a place to do it, which will more likely get you the foot in the door at the venue, rather than just hitting them up before booking other bands and being like, hey, my band lives 20 hours away from here. Can we play your venue? And then they'll be like, but who's gonna come see your band? So yeah, booking the bands first just gives you a little bit of leverage. And when messaging both venues and bands, always mention money. Now, the reality is that if you can't guarantee a certain amount of people, it's hard to ask for a guaranteed amount of money, especially when you're new to playing an area. But you also don't want to go completely broke, so figure out how you're going to get paid. Don't wait to get to the show and then just expect it at the end. Talk about it ahead of time so it's a little more clear and you can take it into account when you're figuring out whatever costs you have just to go on the tour. All right, so now you've sent out a ton of messages. Message some bands, message some venues, and you're starting to figure out how to lock in a show for each date of the tour. From here, you have to be patient and flexible, but also take consistent action. Tour booking is a lot of work. And when you first start doing it, you might get a lot of people that don't answer your messages, and you also might get a lot of people that just turn you down. But don't get discouraged. If you send out a message and then don't hear back within a few days, just send a follow-up. If you waited another few days and you still don't hear back from that, it's time to start thinking about a plan B for that date. 9 times out of 10, when you're booking your own tours, your original tour route is going to be changed. You might not have luck in certain places that you wanted to play initially, and then you have to figure out some alternatives around them. Or maybe you reach out to a band with a specific date and they say, hey, we can't play that date, but we actually have a show the next day that you could play. And then you might want to just take that show and fill in the date. But that'll cause you to have to change your route up a little bit. Just recognize that when you're booking a tour, you're gonna have to be putting a little bit of work into this each day to try to lock in all the dates that you set out to play. If you just wait around to get answers to some of your messages, it may end up getting to be too late, and the closer you get to the date, the harder it's gonna be to book the show. So that about covers my tips for booking your first tour. I'll definitely do another episode down the line where I talk about just general touring tips, but I think this is a solid start just to get the ball rolling on booking some shows. If I missed anything or you have any questions, or if you have a different experience from booking your own tours, let me know down in the comments. And please like this video and subscribe to the channel because I do make these videos weekly. And remember that tour booking only gets easier the more you do it and you get out and meet more people. So I really hope this episode helped you out. I'll see you next week.